We're going to try and tackle this afternoon the dimension that was said at the end of the second of the economic sessions this morning had been left out of the debate. The whole question of migration and its impact on policies. And for the purpose of our discussion this afternoon, we're looking at it from two dimensions, a European perspective and a perspective from the United States. These are very different, but both have manifested in a much sharper way in the course of the last 5 or 6 years for reasons that we all understand. Let's just very briefly try and frame the issue. The latest global migration report of the IOM indicates that there are about 244 million international migrants in 2015, which is the last year for which they have authoritative figures. Now, that is in addition to another 741 million internally displaced persons or migrants within their own countries. So in simple terms, about 1 billion people are in fact moving around at the present time. That trend, that tendency seems likely to increase, firstly because of levels of geopolitical instability, present uncertainty, gaps between circumstances, economic and otherwise, in the developing and the developed world, and then on top of that, the uncertain impacts of climate change on significant parts of the developing world. So this challenge of migration, which has already produced significant political consequences, is unlikely to go away. And developing some sort of coherent sense of how to manage it effectively has already engaged the attention of the international community with a desire to create a global treaty on migration as well as a separate treaty on refugees in the course of 2018. That seems unlikely to be realized in a satisfactory manner at present, but nonetheless, that's the frame of where we are. Now, we have on the panel this afternoon an extraordinarily knowledgeable and skilled group of people capable of addressing this issue. In good form, I'm not going to read out their bios. You have the biography booklets, but we have, from my left to my right, Jean-François Coupier, who was, of course, mayor of Meaux in France, a lecturer at Sciences Po, an associate professor at the University of Paris 8. We have Jim Hoagland, who is a consulting and contributing editor to Washington Post since 2010, having been associate editor and chief correspondent for decades before that. We have Bogdan Klitsch, the minority leader of the Polish Senate, who has also served as Minister of Defense until 2011. And we have Laszlo Toksanyi, who is Minister of Justice in Hungary since 2014 and is a lawyer by profession, a head of the faculty and professor of law at a university in Hungary as well. So a variety of different perspectives, a variety of different insights, and great experience.